On the still waters of this inlet in Palawan, tourists cram rowboats to see this underground river, one of the new seven wonders of nature. This is in the Philippines, a place that this group of Americans is here visiting for work. Maria Lee never expected to enjoy.
Everything, the food, the people, they're just very friendly.
An unexpected surprise for these first-time visitors. The lack of recognition about all the Philippines has to offer is the driving force behind this, the country's global tourism campaign. A catchy ad, but there's a problem. The government didn't have a lot of money for a global media blitz. What it did have? The pride of millions of Filipinos.
We start with the intent that we want to make the nation into a sales force, okay? And we say, yeah, what tools do we give them to go out and sell? We need something open and flexible, tapping into the fact that there are 27 million Filipinos on Facebook.
So the It's More Fun campaign hit social media, urging users to fill in the blanks themselves.
It's more fun in the Philippines.
The smart aleck in me kind of just lit up, and I thought, hey, I could do better.
Roland Benzon and Morn Corpus came up with a series of their own catch lines and matched them to Corpus's pictures, like mountain bikes, more fun in the Philippines, and social climbing, more fun in the Philippines.
There was a point probably after 48 hours or maybe 72 hours, I had about over 10,000 shares on Facebook.
Thousands of Filipinos did the same, making the hashtag It's More Fun in the Philippines the number one trending item on Twitter.
But once the campaign hit social media, users began playing with the template to highlight not just the beauty, but the problems in the country, posting corruption, more fun in the Philippines, crime, more fun, and guns, more fun in the Philippines.
The intentions are excellent. So what is needed for tourism is the infrastructure.
University of the Philippines professor Winnie Monsad says the country needs more than just a witty campaign. It needs to fix problems like Manila's choking traffic and pollution, as well as safety concerns.
The communities themselves must make the country user-friendly. For example, for the taxi drivers, you know, in the airport must be gotten into the project so that they don't try to hold up or to try to exploit the tourists.
It's the nature of social media, you can't control it. But the numbers show the global online chatter may be paying off. Tourism numbers are at record levels this year, a trend that the country hopes will continue not just on social media, but in its natural wonders. Kyung Law, CNN, Puerto Princesa, Palawan, the Philippines.